What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com. Welcome to the second tutorial in the For All series and the sixth one in the bulk data processing series. Today we will learn how to use For All statement with the first bound clause, which is lower and upper bound. Before starting, let's understand one thing. For all statement does the same work as the bulk collect clause, but in the inverse manner. For example, with bulk collect, we were fetching the data from the tables and storing it into the collection. But now with for all statement, we will fetch the data from the collection and store it into the table. That being said, let's come back to our first bound clause of for all statement, which is lower and upper bound. In lower and upper bound, we have to specify the valid range of consecutive index numbers of the collection. Taking both the points which we discussed so far, let's do an example and try to understand for all statement with lower and upper bound clause more clearly. So, with for all statement, we fetch the data from the collection and store it into the table, which means we need a collection with some data and a table into which we can dump that data. Let's first set the server output on and then start with creating a new table for holding the data. Here is the table. Just to keep the demonstration simple, we have a table with no constraints on it and consists only of column MUL underscore tab for holding the multiplication table. No fancy stuff. I think it is simple enough to easily understand the concept. Let's move ahead. Next, we will write a PLSQL block into which we will be creating a collection and then populating it with some data. Then using for all statement, we will dump that data into our table tut underscore 77. So let's do it. Before writing the execution section, let's quickly take a look at what we have done in the declaration section. Here in this section, we have declared an associative array with the name my underscore array along with its collection variable. For more details on associative arrays, you can refer to my PLSQL tutorial number 57. I will leave the link in the description below. Next to the associative array, we have declared another variable with the name tot underscore rec of number data type. We will use this variable to check how many records are fetched from the collection and stored into the table. Now let's move ahead. We have started our execution section with a for loop. Using this numeric for loop, we are populating our collection my underscore array with the multiplication table of 9. Task number 1, creating a table, is done. Task number 2, declaring and populating the collection, is also done. These two tasks set the stage for the demonstration of the for all statement. Now we are left with the last task. Here, we will take the data from the collection my underscore array and store it into the table tut underscore 77 using for all statement. So let's write the for all statement. Here is our for all statement. In this statement, we have used 1 as our lower bound and 10 as our upper bound. The DML operation which we are performing using our for all statement is insert. Using this insert DML, we are inserting values into our table tut underscore 77. So, what are these values? These are the values which we inserted into the collection my underscore array. As you know that, there are two mandatory rules that must be followed while writing the for all statement. These rules are, firstly, a for all statement can have only one DML statement at a time. Secondly, that DML statement in its either values or where clause must reference the collection whose indexes we used in our bound clause. Let's analyze our for all statement. Our for all statement has only one DML, which is insert. And this insert DML statement is referencing the collection my underscore array through the collection variable col underscore var in its values clause, which means both the rules are being fulfilled and we are good to go. Let's do one more thing before execution. Just to ensure that our program has executed as we expected, we have these two statements here. Using the first statement, we are storing the value, which is the total number of records of the table tut underscore 77 into the variable tot underscore rec. And using the second statement, which is an output statement, we are displaying back that value from the variable tot underscore rec to the user. If the output of this TBMS output statement is 10, then we can say that our program has executed successfully. This is because we have programmed our for all statement to insert only 10 records into our table. I'm expecting there is no data initially stored into this table as we have just created it. So let's execute this program and raise the curtains. Here is our result, and fortunately it is 10. This means the program worked as per our expectations. Every execution of this program will append 10 records to the previously stored data in the table, and the result of this output statement will change accordingly. Hope this demonstration helped you in understanding the concepts of for all with the lower and upper bound clause. If so, then do make sure to hit the thumbs up button and like the video. Also, share it with your friends on your social media and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. This is the tutorial on bulk data processing with PLSQL for all statement with the first bound clause, that is lower and upper bound in Oracle database. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.